Hi, the Lonely Buccaneer here. These days, I think it's pretty trendy to be an entrepreneur. Lots of people want their own company and work for themselves. Or maybe it's just Facebook algorithm. But in this video, I'll be talking about 4 things that you forgot to consider if you want to become an entrepreneur. So all the ideas I'm about to share is inspired by the book 10% Entrepreneur by Patrick J. McGinnis, a venture capitalist from New York. Don't get me wrong, I'm a big believer of going all in without holding back, but I think that there's a right time to do it. And the author points out a few things that people don't really think about when taking the jump. So one thing we never hear is that if you're just starting out and have no capital, the entrepreneur lifestyle is lousy. The time and focus required to launch and leading a company takes a toll on you and everyone around you. I know from experience that it was really hard for me when I first quit my job for a few months to try to build something on the side. At that point, I didn't have a set plan, so I was against the wall and I had to find ways to take my skills and use them differently. It forced me to find out what makes me valuable outside of what I was doing for 8 hours a day. And even if I was spending most of my time learning and testing various things, I didn't really have anything that really works. And this brings us to the second point, which is you can ruin your finance. And since at that time I had nothing to show for, it means that there is no income coming in. And this was putting a tremendous amount of pressure on my finance. And even if I was making some money from freelancing website, I couldn't be certain. For example, I could be getting a new customer a week and then he would promise me to do bigger projects for a longer period of time, but then the week after, he decides to go somewhere else. But in spite of the uncertainty, being an entrepreneur is like going on a roller coaster. There is a lot of ups and downs, which is part of the process and makes it way more fun than being on a merry-go-round and do the same thing over and over again. And every challenge I encounter, it forced me to find a solution and grow. The third point is that if you're not already successful, quitting your job means abandoning status and affirmation. For most people, their job denotes their place in society, and a prestigious career brings respect and affirmation. Not only from colleagues, but also from families and friends. And this is something that I didn't consider. Because every time I was going out, I've always felt like a little ashamed to tell people that I didn't have a job and I didn't have much income coming in. And even if I don't care much about what people think, when the comments are coming from family members, it does sting. And that's how I realized that the choice I've made to quit my job changed the way I was perceived by others. And after a while, it was also messing with the way I perceive myself. It was playing with my mind, and I even started to doubt the decision I made. Finally, the last point is, you don't have the right idea yet. Now that I think of it, this point couldn't be more true. My first idea and probably even my first 5 business ideas weren't good because I was simply not experienced enough to build these kinds of business, or neither I knew where to start. I think that when we're starting, we get that big, giant, very generic idea that we're gonna build something that's gonna change the world. But when it comes to do it, we have no idea of where to start, where to get the money from, who can help us, and why we want to do it. And that's why I think that the best way to start is to keep your day job, save a portion of your money to test ideas, build things, and start generating some side income. I think that having a job allows us to have a constant stream of income to take risk. It also allows us to leverage our experience to get clients for your business because it adds credibility. I know that at the moment I need a job because I want that peace of mind. And I also enjoy not having enough time. It creates that sense of urgency where I feel like I'm always behind and running to catch up. I like to finish work, go home, work from 8 to 12. Even if I don't get as much done as I want, it keeps me excited for the weekend. So being a 10% entrepreneur is really about being more productive and allocate our time towards something that we're passionate about. And the author also suggests another alternative, and that is being an advisor. As an advisor, your expertise is your currency. For example, if you're a lawyer and would love to learn more about business, you can trade your knowledge of the law in exchange for 0.2 to 2% of a company's share for committing a certain amount of hours per month. I think that this is a great opportunity to learn about different fields and gain more experience to eventually start something of your own. So to recap, if you want to become an entrepreneur, learn the craft, get things rolling first, then take the leap when you feel ready and you have something going on. So I hope that you liked this video, and make sure to share and subscribe. And until next time, I hope I brought you one step closer to your brighter self.